welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a while since my last video, but I've just been super busy and I haven't gotten any time to kind of sit down and make a video for you guys. But for this video today, I thought I'd share some tips on how to take photos inside. As you might have noticed in my Instagram feed, most of my recent photos are taken outside, but now that autumn is almost over and we're heading into winter, we'll just have to get a little bit creative and work with what we can find at home. And I'm also guessing that a lot of you guys are gonna be spending a lot of time at home as well. And so I thought I'd just give some quick tips that I use when I take photos inside, and hopefully you can use these in your photo shoots as well. So my first tip is to take photos in front of a large window. What I usually do is I push my bed next to the window, and that way the light coming from outside can kind of highlight the subject in my photos. Now shedding leaves, they don't give a hoot. My second tip is to create a color palette. When you're taking photos inside, you can't really rely on the beautiful colors of nature. Instead, you have to create your own color palette using things you can find at home. There are some things you can take into consideration, and you can start by kind of looking at the background. What colors are in the background? Is there like a main color that you can kind of work around and try to match your outfit to it? And when you've picked a good outfit that kind of go with the background colors, you can start focusing on adding props that are also included in that color palette. And in this photo, for example, I wanted to create like a very autumnal photo shoot. I wanted to make sure that the outfit and the props match the beautiful scenery appearing outside the window. And as you can see, the main colors are green, and then there's a little bit of a hint of orange in the upper corner. And so for my outfit, I chose to kind of match the golden and orange tones in the trees, and also matching the green colors in the muted flowers. And for this, you can also play around with like accessories or plants or like paintings, vases, anything you can find really. And as you can see, all of these photos are taken in the exact same spot, and all I've really done is to change up the props or the outfits or like rearrange the furniture a little bit. My point is, you can create a lot of different kinds of photo shoot in the same spot by just changing up like different details. My third tip is to use decorative mirrors. And I'm sure you've seen these kinds of mirrors all over Instagram, but I think they're really a great way to add some like interesting detail to a photo, especially when you don't have that much to work with. Then taking your photos through like a little decorative mirror can kind of frame the photo in a nice way. And what I think works best with these kinds of photos is by placing the mirror either in like a window or at least near a window, so that the light from outside can kind of highlight the subject. And the same thing applies here. Try to focus on one specific color palette, and yeah, just find props and kind of place them surrounding the mirror. My fourth tip is to add texture to the background. And what I mean by that is, if you're, for example, shooting against like a white wall, it can kind of, it tends to look kind of boring. So what you can do is either hang up an old sheet or place some interesting portraits in the background or like paintings, but basically anything to kind of bring a little more shape into the photo. And I'm not sure if I'm explaining this well, but here are some examples of photos that I took. And I just basically took an old sheet and taped it to the wall, and yeah, this is the outcome. I think it makes the photo look a lot more professional. And my last tip is, again, to take your photos through a mirror. But this time, I mean a bigger mirror, so that you don't need anyone to take your photos for you. You can, or you don't even need a tripod, you can just take the photos yourself. So what I usually do is just place the mirror next to a window, again, so the light falls kind of upon the subject, and then I just pick the photo through the mirror. And yeah, if you don't want the phone to be visible in the photo, then you can just kind of crop out a part of the photo. I think it makes it look very painting-like. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. I hope these tips were at least somewhat helpful. I don't know if they seem pretty obvious, but it's what I use when I take my photos. My point is that there are a lot of creative ways to take photos inside, and you don't have to give up completely just because you can't take aesthetic photos outside anymore. And yeah, let me know if you have any questions, and I'll be happy to answer them in the comments below. And other than that, I just hope you'll have a lovely rest of your day, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!